we need to hear the word of God. Don't run away. Don't go away. God has special a message to you to change your life and your family. I know many people, they like prayer and worship. After the prayer and worship, they run away. So don't run away. You don't know where your help comes from. God is one. It doesn't matter whether is God, who is God. God is just one God. And we worship him. This is the God we trust. It is our God, our Heavenly Father. Whether you are a Muslim, Hindu, wherever you are, we have one God and one man. That is God. So let's hear the word of God. You may not know where your help comes from. Yes, thank you so much. So I'm going to read to you the word from Mark 1, verse 35. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Mark 1, verse 35. This is Jesus himself. Jesus was preaching, praying. The time reached when he has to run away. The time has when he decided to flee away. Every time has his own time. Now let's look at this at the scripture. The Bible says, let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you so much for this morning. I thank you for my friends in Periscope. I thank you for the connection that you have made to me through this Periscope. Lord, I thank you for Periscope. And I give you all the glory. I know that, God, you didn't bring these people for fun, for accident. I know you have special message, you have special thing for them. I pray that God touch their life, God. Meet their needs, God, my Father. They are your people. They are your children, God. I bring them to you, my Father. I pray special, special, special deliverance to their lives, God. Those who have needs, Lord, meet their needs, my Father. They are your people. They are your children. I commit them to you. You are our Father. We have you, only one God. We don't have two gods. We only have Jehovah God who lives in heaven. And we appreciate you and thank you so much. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we give you the glory. I invite the Holy Spirit. I invite the presence of the Holy Spirit to fall upon us in the name of Jesus. Thank you, my God. I commit this word into your hand. And I bless you and I give you the glory. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. I'm going to read to you the book of Mark 1, 35. The Bible says, Mark 1, 35. The Bible says, and in the morning, rising up a great while before day, he went out and departed into the solitary place and there prayed. So Jesus rose up early in the morning and then he went to a solitary place. So after doing all this work, after praying a lot of prayer, after healing so many people, he has to fly, he has to flee, he has to run away, to go to a isolated place where he can go and seek God and pray to his Father. Now, when his disciples were looking for him, he found him and tell him that people are looking for you. They tell him, no, let me stay away from people because I want to seek my God first. So there's a time you will know how to fight and how to flee away from people. There's the time you need to know what do you want to do. This time, if Jesus did not run away from this, he could not do well. So he fight, he did everything, and people were healed. And the Bible tells us in the book of First Timothy, hallelujah. Let's say something in the book of 1 Timothy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God, you are so good. The Bible says, 1 Timothy 6:12. The Bible says, fight the good fight of the faith. Take hold of the eternal life to which you were called when you made your good confession in the presence of many witnesses. So here, Paul is telling us, fight a good one, a good fight. When you know how to fight, you will fight a good one. You will never fail. That's why when Jesus was fighting was fighting the demons, fighting the devil, fighting all people who were possessed. So he had to fly away. He has to run away from them after doing all this job. And then Paul says, it's good to know how to fight a good one. When you fight a good fight, you also have appreciated. Thank you. Jesus did very good job. He healed so many people. A lot of multitude and multitude were healed. If you look at that scripture, Mark 1, let's go back. Mark 1, let's go back to verse 29. Mark 1, 29. You see the good fight that Jesus fought. So we look at that. After Jesus left the synagogue with James and John, they went to Simeon and Andrew's home. Now, Simeon's mother-in-law was sick in bed with high fever. They told Jesus about her right away. So he went to her beside, took her hand by hand and helped her sit up. Then the fever left her, and she prepared a meal for them. Simeon's mother-in-law, Peter, you know, some disciples were married. Some disciples of Jesus were having wives. Some people, they think that the disciples of Jesus were not married. Some were married, some were not married. Some were young youth, some were not married. Here, the Bible tells us, the mother-in-law, Peter, Apostle Peter, the disciples of Jesus, his mother-in-law was sick, and Jesus went and helped her, and the mother-in-law was healed. So, when people saying that the disciples of Jesus were not married, that is a lie. That is error. The disciples of Jesus, some were married, some were not married. Like Jesus was not married. So people, they confused, they say Jesus married. That's a lie from the pit of hell. Jesus did not marry, and Jesus did not have any affairs. He was a spirit. He was born through the spirit. So Jesus himself, he was a spirit. He was not a human being like us. He came as a human being, but naturally he was not a human being. That's why he died and he was resurrected. He went to heaven. And this time, that's why we celebrate him. Jesus never did any sin. Jesus was sinless. He grew up as us. He grew up like us, like any child. He went through childhood. He was circumcised like any child. After 8 days, he was circumcised. He grew like a human being like us, so that we can believe that he is the Son of the living God. Now, Peter and the other apostles, they had their wives. Yeah? So Jesus did not want to leave the wife a widow or husbandless. If he married here and he was to leave, where would Jesus leave his children? So he didn't want to do that. That's why he didn't marry. So, because even Paul was doing a lot of work. He has so much missionary. That's why he was not able to marry. Even me, I have children, but my children are grown up. When I started the ministry, my children was young, but now they are grown up. If right now I could have babies, I don't know whether I will take care of them, because I don't have time to look after them. Yeah? When you involve them to the ministry, and you have young people, young kids to raise up, it is difficult. That's why Paul even didn't want to marry. He was traveling. He was going all over to do the mission work. So he didn't have time to look for a woman, to look for children. He was devoted to serve God. So not everybody who can marry or who can have children. Some people, they must have children. They have to marry and have children. Some, they are called people, many people are called different. And God is our witness that we have to give birth, we have to have children, so we cannot focus, or we cannot say that we can't have children. That's wrong. So that's why I want to prove to you that Peter, Apostle Peter, was married with his wife and children. Now, this is what happened. That evening, after sunset, many sick and demon-possessed people were brought to Jesus. The whole town gathered at the door to watch. You see, the whole town, the whole city, like here in Brampton, or your city, all of them, the whole city, They came to watch what is going on. So when Jesus looked at like this, he said, I have to fly away. I have to run and hide myself to seek more power. So the Bible says people were sick with various diseases and he cast out many demons. But because the demons knew who he was, he did not allow them to speak. So now the demon knew who he was, so he didn't give them a chance to speak. That's one way. If you know how to fight, you don't have to give your enemy any minute to speak or to exchange to you. When you know how to fight, that's why the title says you should know how to fight. When Jesus noticed that these people, they brought a lot of demons possessed, a lot of people were healed and healed them. Then because the demons knew who he was, he did not allow them to talk to them. That's why after doing this, he decided to run away from them and went to the isolated place, separate place, where even his disciples did not know. And they prayed. Jesus prayed there, and then they found him, and he has to go to another city because he wanted to help other people. Therefore, it's good to know how to fight a good fight. And that's why Paul is saying, if you should not learn how to fight a good fight, a good one. You don't go to fight where you are defeated. You fight a good fight for the faith. Take hold of the eternal life to which you were called when you made your good confession in the law in the presence of many witnesses. So that's why we know that if you know how to fight, good one, you cannot be defeated. No demon from hell would defeat you in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I want to see some of the scripture. When we look at 1 Corinthians 9, verse 25, the Bible says, everyone who competes in the games goes into strictly training. Therefore, they do it to get crowd that would not rust, but we do it to get a crown that will last forever. So when you know how to fight, when you go to anybody who knows how to fight, you have to train yourself properly. That's why you need a lot of prayer. You need to read your Bible. You need to get the Holy Ghost fire to guide you, to do good fight. It's when you can win. The Bible is sports is here in the Bible. Don't think that the sport started from anywhere. The sport started right from the Bible. The Bible tells us that everyone who competes in the games goes into strict training. If you see those people who are competing, who are stars, they have to train themselves. They have to discipline themselves. And they love their coach. They love their supervisor. They have their captain. They are obedient. They obey. They are ready to be trained and humble themselves. That's why they win. So this the word of God. I'm here to help you and train you and coach you how to go with the word of God so that you can be a winner. You cannot be defeated when you know how to fight a good one and you know how to flee. There's a time you have to hide yourself. You cannot expose yourself. Elijah, the man of God, who was calling fire from heaven. There was a time a woman said, I'm coming for you to kill you, Elijah. Elijah did not wait. He hid himself. He ran for his life. He fled. Elijah, prophet Elijah, the one who was calling fire. So he said, I'm not waiting for a woman to come and kill me. I have to hide. He ran away. He fled away. The same thing when Jesus noticed that these people, they are going to kill me. Jesus also flee away from them. He went to a isolated place. So there's a time you have to hide, to go and seek the kingdom of God, to go and seek the face of God. You look at the ego. When the ego is tired, he is worn out, he goes to the high mountain and hide there. And they stay there until he gains power, energy. I've done this after these 21 days, then I will go for another 7 days. That is it. Then you won't see me in Periscope for some times until I come back with the new fresh because I've given a lot. I've done so much videos. I've done almost 150 videos. So I have to go also to renew myself. That's why I want you, my partner.